Hello and welcome here to Talk NCB and welcome back to the channel here today. And of course, we are going to be previewing the round two of the La Liga season, which is going to be a very, very exciting game. We travel to San Mamés to take on Athletic Club, and it's going to be a really enthralling tie because it's one of those games which when the fixture list come out at the start of the season, you're looking at it, you're thinking, when are we going to go to San Mamés? Because it's often quite a very, very difficult visit. We've had trouble there in the past. Recently, we've been okay there, apart from, of course, when you think back to the very beginning of last season when we went there in the Super Cup and got absolutely annihilated. But the good thing was we bounced back straight away. We actually went there one game before this one last season. We went there on the opening day of last season and we won 1-0 thanks to a Luis Suarez volley on that day. We defended in numbers. It was a really scrappy 1-0 win, not like Barca at all, but we got through it. And certainly San Mamés can do that to you because the crowd are good. They're very, very tight to the pitch. They're very, very passionate there. They support their club. And they've got some very, very good players, Athletic. We all know about their transfer policy. They don't sign an awful lot of players because they only sign players of Basque descent. But certainly one player that may well have a very big influence on Sunday's game is Aritz Aderiz. Of course, the player who went to the European Championship this summer wasn't given an awful lot of chance by Vicente Del Bosque. But certainly last season, he was in absolutely sensational form. 34 games, 20 goals, and chipped in with 6 assists as well. And Athletic had a decent season themselves. They're going to be looking to kick on. They're going to be looking at possibly getting into the European places. And certainly they're going to give us a very, very good game tomorrow, especially after they had a very disappointing defeat to Sporting Gijón in the first game of their season, losing 2-1 on the night. So they're going to be coming at us with everything. They're going to be coming at us with passion, hard work. They're going to be closing us down very early on. They're going to try and get the crowd behind them. We've certainly got to start the game fast. We've got to start the game very, very committed. And every single player on that pitch has got to understand they've got to be right at it from the moment go. We can't allow any mistakes. We can't be allowed to go behind in this game because they're a very, very difficult team to break down. That they're, you know, they defend in numbers. And certainly we're going to need to be on our mettle tomorrow if we're going to come out of the San Mamés with all 3 points. But like I say, we have had good results against Athletic as of late. We won there, like I say, on the opening day of last season. From then, though, it was really, really good performances from us against them. We actually played them 3 times in the space of 10 days at the beginning of this year. In January, we faced them at home in the league. We won 6-0 on the night. Very, very big influence. There was a red card very, very early on for the goalkeeper, Iraizos, in that game. A Luis Suarez hat-trick, not out of place in any game at the moment. And then we played them twice over the course of the Copa del Rey, winning 2-1 away from home once again, victorious at the San Mamés, and we also won 3-1 at the Camp Nou. So certainly recently against Athletic, we performed very, very well indeed. All 4 games since the Super Cup, we've gone on to win, and that's good for us going into this game. But it's not going to matter an awful lot. Once you get out there, once the fans are on your back, it's all about getting the right performance. And Luis Enrique's got a very, very big decision to make in terms of the players that he selects in this game. Still no Neymar. He is going to be away until the international break, which is next week, by the way, guys. Next week will be a full round of international matches, meaning no league football. And personally, I think that's far too early in the season to put an international break. I think, you know, we've only just kicked off the season. Please let club football stay around for a bit longer before you interrupt it again with international matches. We've had the Euros. We have the Copa America, we have the Olympics. Just let us play for a bit before interrupting the season again. But sadly, next week is the international break. And after that, then, Neymar as well as Andres Iniesta will be returning to the lineup. Hopefully on that international break, we don't suffer any injuries. But of course, if we do now, we've got a squad that can deal with it. And that's what Luis Enrique has going into tomorrow's game. Mascherano and Ter Stegen are both expected to be welcomed back into the team for this one. Titi played very, very well against Real Betis. So it's going to be very interesting to see whether Luis Enrique elects to stick with him to get the centre of defence or go back to Mascherano and those leadership qualities and the outstanding form, really, that we saw from Mascherano at the end of last season. Ter Stegen, of course, will certainly come in and play in goal. He'll replace Claudio Bravo, of course, who's gone now to Manchester City, although Jasper Cillessen is also available for selection after signing for the club this week officially. So that's good. You know, we're starting to get some of our squad back now. It'll be really nice after the international break to have Neymar and Iniesta back. I think possibly in this game we'll look again to sort of replicate the sort of shape that we showed against Real Betis with Arda Turan in the front three. He played very, very well there. And what Arda Turan allowed us to do was sort of switch between a 4-3-3 and a 4-4-2. You know, when we needed to defend, when we needed to win the ball back, when we needed that midfield steal, Arda Turan would just drop in to that midfield area. The same goes for Lionel Messi. He could just drop into that midfield. And then when we needed to attack, when we were on the front foot, Arda Turan and Messi as well would slot back into that forward line. So it's going to be very, very interesting to see the influence once again tomorrow of Lionel Messi. He was outstanding against Real Betis in the opening game of the season, looked really motivated, looked really up for the season going ahead. So let's going to see what comes from him tomorrow. But it's also going to be very, very interesting to see how many more goals Luis Suarez can score. And that is the guy that we're going to focus on here, because he scored the winner last season at San Mamés and he had a hat-trick on the opening day against Real Betis. One more match ball for his ever-growing collection, and he has been absolutely sensational. Words cannot put into, you know, description really how good he's been since he arrived with us, and it really is incredible numbers that he's showing. In his last six league matches, Luis Suarez has scored four hat-tricks, in that time scoring a total of 17 goals. Those are stats which you would not even get playing FIFA. You honestly wouldn't. He is on a different level right now. Really incredible in terms of goal scoring. He's scored 10 hat-tricks now in his Barcelona career. That's one hat-trick on average every 10 matches, which is just sensational. Some players don't score a hat-trick in a season. Some players don't even score a hat-trick in a few years. Luis Suarez gets one most weekends. Really, it's incredible. And it's going to be very interesting to see exactly what he can do at the San Mamés again this weekend. Barca, like I said, good form of late against Athletic. They've actually scored in every single one but one of their last 37 league matches against Athletic. So certainly in that time that we've been facing them, we always look to play on the front foot, we'll always look to attack, and we will certainly tomorrow be looking to score that first goal. And then once we've got it, we can look to defend it. Then we can be methodical, we can look to hit them on the break. And like I say, there will be some big players returning tomorrow. Ter Stegen, possibly Mascherano at the centre of defence. It depends on what Luis Enrique elects to go with. But it's going to be interesting as well to see it right back. Is he going to go with Vidal? Is he going to go possibly again with Sergio Roberto, who played so well in that opening game against Real Betis? Joel Diarra on the left side. But of course, once again, Lucas Digne has put in some very good displays as well. So it's really, really nice right now that we've got a squad of players that really can push for places in the midfield, even though we've got Iniesta injured, you've got Denis Suarez, of course, Andre Gomez, who wasn't even in the squad against Real Betis last weekend. I'd certainly expect him to be included in some way, shape or form on Sunday. And of course, again, after the international break, there's the return of Rafinha, who's almost been forgotten, a player that was so, so good before that serious injury. He's going to be coming back as well as Neymar after the international break, and that's another player that we've got to add to our squad. So certainly an attack as well. We've got numbers, even without Neymar. We've got Arda Turan, we've got Munir on the bench, who's been showing some good promise whenever he's been given minutes. And of course, like I've already mentioned, you've got the dynamic duo that is Lionel Messi and Luis Suarez. So it's going to be a great game. They always are at the San Mamés. It's going to be entertaining. I'm sure at times it's going to be nerve-wracking, but I really do hope that we can come out of there with all 3 points. Because like I said, it's good to face these teams early on in the season. You can hit the ground running. You can tick them off the list. Once we get through this game, we can get the 3 points. We can say, right, we've done San Mamés. All the other teams have got to go there. Real Madrid, Atletico, they've still got to go there and pick up points. Put the pressure on them. Get the points on the board and keep moving forward. So leave your thoughts down below, guys. What are you expecting to come out of this game? How sort of highly do you rate it? How highly do you rate the opposition? Like I say, Athletic in that opening game did lose to Sporting Gijón. Adarice didn't get on the score sheet. Like I said earlier, he'll be looking to get off the mark after the outstanding season that he had last season. Athletic currently in 14th position. Barcelona very much top of the table, and that's exactly where we'd like to stay. So leave your thoughts down below. Like I'm saying, I think it's going to be a good game. I think it's going to be a tense game, and I think the winner of this one really will feel like they're certainly off the mark this season. And if we can get 6 points from our opening two games going into that international break, our goal difference should just about ensure that we stay top of the league if we win this one after our thumping victory against Real Betis on that opening day. So if we can get the points, keep the positive energy going, go into the international break with 100% record. Atletico have already dropped points. Real Madrid play at home to Celta Vigo this weekend, so they've not got such an easy game either. It's going to be very, very interesting to see how these games go this weekend and what points are picked up, and of course, if any points are lost. So I'm interested to hear your thoughts as always, guys. Thanks as always for all the support, all the comments, all the likes. This is Talk FCB. That is the point. Get talking, get discussing, get, you know, verging your opinions. Let me know everything. I'll see you very, very soon. Of course, I'll be here for the review and everything that goes with that. Let's hope it's a positive one, and I'll be back soon. Vesca! El Barça!